Hi, and happy April to you. Isn't it great we're already through 3 months of 2020? I don't know if you had any April Fool's Day jokes pulled on you, but hopefully if you did, you laughed about it and went on with it. I'm wearing a specific and significant sweater today. This is my Where's Steve sweater, if you can see it, or maybe you're familiar with Wells' Where's Waldo, maybe not. If so, go online and look it up. I wanted to share with you a couple of verses today. Proverbs 15:15. All the days of the oppressed are wretched, but the cheerful heart has a continual feast. Proverbs 15:30. Light in a messenger's eyes brings joy to the heart, and good news gives health to the bones. Do you have a cheerful heart? Let me give you some good news. 1 Timothy 1:15. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Isn't it great that Jesus came to die for your sins? Luke 19:10, for the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost. Isn't that great news? I'm glad you've responded to Jesus. And if you haven't responded to Jesus, I encourage you to do that. But if you have, you have eternal life. Not everyone has responded to his call. And I think there are many around us right now that are lost. They are lost knowing what to do because many things have pulled them from, been pulled out from under them. And maybe you have the opportunity to lead them to Christ even right now. John 4:35 says, do you not say there are yet 4 months, and then comes the harvest? Look, I tell you, lift up your eyes and see the fields are white for harvest. We are thinking harvest is some time yet away. But maybe there's someone around you in your block, in your neighborhood, that is right on the tips of knowing Christ because they have nowhere else to turn. Lead them to Jesus Christ. I also have an idea for us as we go forward. We've been separated, and I thought maybe there's a way we could connect. Could you possibly take a picture of yourself or your family, maybe a selfie, or have somebody take a picture of you, of something you've been doing in recent days, and text it to me at 605-430-3019. If I can get over 30 photos, and then maybe next week in our YouTube video, we can have a photo montage sharing of what we've been doing as a church family. Maybe it'll prove an encouragement to others. For example, here is my photo of my family. This past week, we were able to go down south of, or actually east of Custer, and go find the Meeker cabin. I don't know if you've ever found that, but this is what we found, and here we are standing in front of the cabin. Maybe you have been able to be somewhere in recent days. Snap a photo. Get these to me by April 6th, and if we have enough, then we'll have a photo montage next YouTube greeting. I want to give you a couple of things also. The building is going to be open on Sunday from 8:30 to 11:30 for anyone wanting to come and pray. We're going to be mindful of others and allow others to pray, and you don't need to feel obligated to come. But if you want to come and pray, know that the church will be open for you to come and pray. If you're ill, please don't come. Stay at home, get well. Also, if you want to come, just to the parking lot and pray. To get out of the house and go for a drive, you could possibly hook into the internet and listen to the sermon at that point in time, or you can just pray in the parking lot, and prayer guides are going to be made available. As a reminder to you, by Friday evening, the sermon will be available, and I encourage you to have an intentional time over the weekend of listening to the message. We're actually going to add probably a song before the message and a song after the message this week, and so feel free to sing along. We are hoping to have an online service on Easter Sunday, April 12 at 10 o'clock. It's going to include some singing led by Pastor Bradley, a prayer time, and a sermon that I will share. Please look next week to how you can access that on Easter Sunday. Another thing we're wanting to do, we're wanting to have a prayer vigil on Saturday, April 11 from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. We would like for you to sign up for a 30-minute time slot and come and pray for our community. From 6 a.m. to 6 p.m., would you be willing to sign up for a 30-minute time slot? If you would be willing, just respond to this email, what time would work for you, or you can text me as well. Another thing you should know is we will not be having a Monday Thursday service because of all that's going on. And I also want to thank you for continuing to give to the ministries of First Wesleyan Church. Many of you have done that, and I hope that through these messages and through the sermon online, you have been encouraged. If you need any assistance, please contact the church office at 605-718-1115. We want to be here for you. Couple of ideas. Don't forget to smile. Maybe your smile can encourage somebody around you. Bring a cheerful heart around the neighborhood. Read the book. Read the Bible and be an encouragement to others. Share with someone the good news. Send your photo in to me, and hopefully next week we can have a photo montage. I'm going back to Proverbs 15:30, and then I will pray for you. Light in a messenger's eyes brings joy to the heart, and good news gives health to the bones. Let me pray for you. Lord, I pray that you would be with each one of us, that you would bring joy to our hearts today. There's a bunch of negative news, but we know that you're on the throne. So I pray that each person that's watching this video will have joy brought from you. And I pray that they would have health in their bones, keep them safe from all harm. And I pray, God, that there would be great joy that would flow out of us that we can share with others, and they can have the joy of you. Thank you, God, that you love us. Continue to draw our hearts to you. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Have a great rest of the week.